हाय ऋषि योगी जी, आई गॉट योर क्वेश्चन। अकॉर्डिंग टू योर क्वेश्चन, योर मेन नेटवर्क इज 192.168.0.0.16। मीन्स आई एम कंसिडरिंग दिस नेटवर्क एज ए सब नेट सॉरी सुपर नेटेड नेटवर्क। ओके, सो व्हाट यू आर मेंशनिंग लाइक क्लासलेस आईपी और क्लासफुल आईपी, सो व्हाट यू आर मेंशनिंग एंड व्हाट यू आर थिंकिंग, दैट्स अनदर पार्ट। आई विल जस्ट कंसीडर द मेन नेटवर्क एंड ऑल द पार्ट्स एंड हाउ मेनी पार्ट्स यू वांट टू डिवाइड द नेटवर्क एंड ऑल द थिंग्स आई हैव टू कंसीडर। ओके, सो सिंपली व्हाट आई विल डू, दिस इज माई मेन नेटवर्क एंड यू आर प्रेजेंटिंग टोटल 16 बिट्स एज नेटवर्क बिट्स। सो हियर यू वॉन्ट टू मेक सम पार्टीशंस और यू वॉन्ट टू स्प्लिट दिस नेटवर्क इन टू 3 पार्ट्स एंड इफ and for the rest part you want to use for the future use, means if you are going to create any new network or something you want to use them. So what I will do here, I can see you have mentioned something like 4000 IP, 1000 IP network, 100 IP network. So I am going to consider these 3 networks right now. So what I will do, so you can think like means I am understanding this one, that you are means you want a solution with VLSM right now. Okay, just because your number of host in the network are vary by network to network, means in one network your host number is 4000, in another network your host number is 1000, and in another network your host number is 100. So according to that, what I will do, first of all I will start doing the subnetting with that network which network is having more number of hosts, means for 4000 IP address I will start first, then in second I will start with the second network which is having IP address of 1000, and in the third case I will start with the network which is having IP address or host number of 100 IP. Okay, so what I will do right now, I will start subnetting from the big network to small network like that one, okay, in a descending order. So as in my old video you have seen, so according to that only I will go. If you are having 4000 IP address, then my block size for this network will be 4096, and I hope you are already aware about this one, why I am taking this number as my block size. And for the second network also I will take the block size as 1024, and the third network I will take the block size as 128. Okay, so according to this only I will proceed. So now I will start the subnetting with the 4000 IP network or for the first network. So as you know, my block size is 4096, so according to the block size I can get the number of host bit that are using in this network. So if I am talking about the host bit that are using in this network, then I will get, how I have to get like that, means with how much bit combination I can get this result like 4096, I have to consider like that. So in this case what I have to do, I have to check, like if I am going for let me count this one, if I am going for 2 to the power 8, then it will be 256, then for 9 512, then for 10 it will be 1024, for 11 it will be 2048, then it will be 2 to the power 12, means it's the combination of total 12 bits which is giving you the result of 4096. So here my host bit will be total 12 bits. Okay, so as you know, in a IP total one IP is consist of 32 bits. From that 32 bits, if 12 bits are for host, then rest 20 bits will be my network bits. So number of network bits will be 32 minus 12 equal to 20 bits. Okay, 20 bits are my network bits, or you can say like 20/20 will be my CIDR value, /20. Okay, because CIDR value actually define the number of network bits in your IP. So now I have idea about the host bit and the network bits in my subnetted network, for the first subnetted network which will have 4000 IP address. Okay, so now I can get the subnet mask also. If I am going to calculate the subnet mask, then you know one subnet mask is in dotted decimal format, and for every octet there will be 8 bits, and as I have 20 bit networks, and then 8 bit I am giving to this octet, 8 bit I am giving to this octet, and rest 4 bit I am taking as network bits from this octet, and rest 4 will be my host bit in that network. So third octet will be my changeable octet, just because in third octet I am having network bits as well as host bits. So in this case, if for first octet, if I am keeping all the bits on, then I will get maximum value up to 55, and for the second octet also I will get the value up to 55. And if I am counting 4 network bits for the third octet, then my value will be 240. Okay, this will be my value. And you know, in the subnet mask where all the host bit means, for this octet you will find all the bits as host bit, so the value will be 0. So this will be 0. So my subnet mask value is right now 255.255.240.0. this is my subnet mask. So now I have to find the range. So as I told you how I will do, I will take the first IP address of the network which have given to me, which is given to me or from my main network. So this is my main network, so I will start from this one. So if I am going to count the range, then I will take 192.168.0.0, and my slash value will be 20, because for this subnetted network my network bits are 20 bits. So I am taking the slash value or CIDR value as 20. So this will be my network bit for the main network as well as for my subnetted network or my fast network range. This will be my network ID. So now I have to get the broadcast ID for this. So for that, what I have to do, I know that on my main network these all are fixed. Like in my main network, the subnet mask or the CIDR value is 16. 16 means 8 bits, 8 bits. 2 octet are already reserved for the network part, or 2 octet are already fixed for the network part. So I can't change those two networks. So I am keeping everything like that only. And I know my third octet is my changeable octet. So if I am doing subnetting, then I have to consider the third octet, because I have to consider the changeable octet. So in my changeable octet, you know, total 4 bits are host bits. So I have to count the block size for the third octet also to get the range. So I am writing here block size of the third octet equal to, so total if I have 4 bits or 4 host bits, then the block size value will be 2^4, which will be 16. So what I have to do now, I have to count from 0 to 16. If I am adding 16 with this 0 value, then I will get 16 value, but I have to write 15 here, just because in networking I am counting this value from 0. So 0 to 15 means total 16 value, or total 16 number of total 16 number of values are here. So at last, as you know, if your changeable octet is third or second octet or something like that, after that in the right side every octet value will be 255 in the broadcast ID. And also I am taking the same CIDR value for this network for my broadcast ID. So this will be my network ID right now, this will be my broadcast ID right now. Rest all the IP like 192.168.1.1.0.1, something like all the IP coming between these two IP will be my host IP. So also now I have to do the subnetting for the rest networks. So for the rest network, you have mentioned like you have total 1000 number of host or 1000 number of IP address. So in this case, I have to consider the block size as 1024. Again, I have to take the host bit. So the number of host bit equal to how many bits combination is coming as 1024. I have to consider like that. So if I am considering that, then I will get like 2^10 equal to 1024. So I have total 10 bits host bit. So if I am having 10 bits in as host bit in this network, so total number of network bits will be 32 minus 10 equal to 22. So you can consider for this subnet, this will be my CIDR value, or total in this network every IP is having 22 bits as network bits. So now I have to count the subnet mask for this one. Same I will do like that. So 8 bits I am giving to this octet, 8 bits I am giving to this octet, then 6 bits I am giving from this third octet. Okay, so and rest 2 bit will be my host bit, and for the last octet every bit will be the host bit. So as I am going to count the subnet marks, as you know, if I am counting all the bits of this octet as one bit, or if I am put using the binary value of 1, or I am counting that as 1 bit, then the value will come as 255 in decimal format for the second host. Sorry, so for the second octet also the value will be 255, and for the third octet, as I have total 8 number of network bits, so if I am counting the decimal value, then for the third octet I will get the decimal value as 252, and the rest all host bit or fourth octet is having all the bits at 0, so the fourth octet value will be 0. So now my subnet mask value is 255.255.252.0. this will be my subnet mask. Now I will get the range. So before starting the range of the network, I will look at the last IP of my fast network. So last IP or broadcast IP of my fast network is 192.168.15.255. So from the next IP only I will use like 192.168.16.0/22, just because I am getting the network ID of CIDR value as 22 for this subnet. Then I will count the range. So I got the network ID, now I have to get the broadcast ID. For this IP also, for this subnet also, you know the third octet is the changeable octet. So as my main network is having /16 CIDR value, so as /16 means, you know, two octets are using as network bits. So these are already the value will be fixed, so I am not going to change anything from these two octets. And what I will change, that will be according to the third octet only, because third octet is my changeable octet. In third octet, if I am trying to find the third octet block size, then it will be 2 to the power 2, just because 2 bits are using for host bit only, so the value will be 4. So I have to use this value to find the range here. So I will do like 16 plus 4, it will come like 20, but I will take the value as 19, just because my value is starting from 16. So if I am counting 16, 17, 18 and 19, total I have 4 values. So as you know, broadcast ID, the octet who is having all the host bits, that will consider as 255, like this also you can understand. And also I am going to use the same CIDR value for the broadcast ID also. And this will be my network ID, this will be my broadcast ID, and rest IP which are coming between these two IP, those will be my host IP or valid host IP which can be used in my network. So for the next, you have asked about 100 IP network. So 100 IP means I have to consider the block size as 128. So number of host bit equal to, for 128 if I am counting, then the number of host bit will be 2 to the power 7, that means 7 bits. So I am going to give 7 bits as host bit, and if I am counting the network bits, then it will be 32 minus 7 which comes 25 bits. So my CIDR value equal to will be /25, or this IP network is having 25 network bits. So same like that, I have to count the subnet mask also. As you know, for subnet mask there is total 4 octets, so every octet is having 8 bit of value. So what I am going to do, first octet 8 bits I am giving the network bits, and also for second and also for third, just because I am having 25 network bits. So for the first octet 8, second octet 8, third octet 8, so total value 24 bits has been used here. So only one network bit left, which I am going to give this network bit from the fourth octet, and the rest all will be the host bit in the fourth octet. And you know the fourth octet is my changeable octet right now. So it's like that I did in the previous subnetting things. Like if all the 4 bits or all the 8 bits are on, then in that case you will get the decimal value of 255. Like that only I am giving 255 for the first, second and third octet. And for the fourth octet, you know, only 1 bit I am using as the network bit. So if I am going to get the decimal value of this binary number, then I will get the decimal value of 128. So my subnet mask will be 255.255.255.128. So right now I have to take the block size of this octet also to get the range. So the fourth octet block size will be 2 to the power 7, which will come 128. So now I have to take the range. So for this range also, I have to consider the last IP of the last network, which is this one, 192.168.19.255. Then I have to take the next IP after this. So if I am counting that, then my next IP will be 192.168.20.0/25, just because this network or this subnet is having 25 network bits, or CIDR value is 25. Then I have to take the broadcast IP. As you know, from this subnet mask, means third octet, three octets, the value is same, like 255 255 255, means for the three octet, first octet, second octet and third octet, all the bits are used as network bits. So I will keep the three octet value as same. Okay, only my changeable octet is the fourth octet, so I will do the changes to my fourth octet only. And the fourth octet block size, you know, it's 128, so I will count like 0 plus 128 equal to 128, but I will write here 127, just because it's starting from 0. So my subnet mask, CIDR value will be 25. So this will be my network ID, this will be my broadcast ID, and rest all the IP will be the valid host IP, or the IP address which can be used for a host.